A very good morning, everyone, and welcome to our webinar series on Palm Oil Certification Educational Program. Today's webinar will be on the Malaysian Palm Oil Certification Council and is jointly organized by MPOCC and the Faculty of Agriculture, UPM. The objective of this webinar is for us to get to know the strategy behind the establishment of MPOCC and its role to uphold and execute MSPO, which is a vital subject in today's palm oil industry. We have a very experienced speaker today, Mr. Hezbollah, who has graciously agreed to take some time to provide his insights on this subject matter. Mr. Hezbollah is a senior manager in strategic management at MPOCC. He is from Sandakan Sabah and graduated from UPM Campus Bintulu with a Bachelor of Bioindustry Science. He started his career as a cadet planter in 2010, followed by becoming an assistant estate manager in 2011 and an internal auditor for operation and finance in 2014. He joined MPOCC in 2016. His interests include Islamic history, investment and finance, governance, sustainability, sports and e-games. Without further ado, I would like to welcome Mr. Hezbollah to take the floor. The stage is yours, Mr. Hezbollah. Welcome.
All right. Thank you, Doctor. Actually, not so experienced, lah. Just still half cooked and still learning. And then, thank you very much for the introduction, Doctor. And also, assalamualaikum and a very good morning to everyone. So, hopefully, not so serious, lah. Kita santai a bit because this is not a final exam, I guess. So. If you have any question you want to interject, please ask, or also maybe you can wait until the end of the presentation. So today presentation, before we start, disclaimer, yeah, disclaimer, any picture, picture, symbol, logo, label used in this presentation slides are intended for the purpose of training, education, awareness and knowledge sharing only. So I didn't make any claim to any of the organization inside here. Just to share some graphic or pictures for everyone understanding lah. All right. So last week, my colleague Mr. Simon already briefed about the very technical insight of certification, including standard, also auditing, and then the need why we need certification due to you know, the environmental impact, social impact, for example. But today, we will discuss, I will bring everyone to explore slightly different dimension from the previous one. We will look into the global, national, and also MPOCC perspective on certification as a whole. It's not really technical on the auditing or ISO or standard lah. And then what we are doing, especially our journey when we started, I mean MSPO started in 2013, and then how we implementing the MSPO, not only in the past years but also moving forward, and also the finally the conclusion lah. What is the challenges and opportunities? All right, this is actually from the. I do some paper review lah, one journal from published in 2018. It says the beginning of sustainability certification is related to forest management system. So ini actually memang if you think logically, in any land use change, perubahan tanah lah, for example, perubahan tanah daripada sebelum pembangunan kepada pembangunan, we all start with forest, and then is either we go for agriculture ataupun kita pergi ke other development lah, macam building, you know, ataupun manufacturing. So it all started from sustainability, from forest. So also I found one paper juga mention about the oldest certification in the world, started in 1941. From American tree farm system. So you can check the website, let me link to, you can check the history of the certification. So dia mention dalam ni mostly on forest juga, but this is started in US lah. And also through the apa ni Food and Agriculture Organization pun, of course forest certification memang is one of the pioneer lah, this sector lah basically. You can see here even in term of global certification, forest memang banyak lah. You see one our we should proud of is the MPCC, Malaysian Timber Certification Council, created in 1998. So you see the apa transition tu. On other sectors pun we have the certification. Okay, you see in from global context, I try to build up the case for us to understand. You know, from 1970s we already have eco-label certification. So it's like a voluntary method of environmental performance certification and labeling. So they should have start 70s in other sectors. Also the I think the big milestone in 1987, Rainforest Alliance, one of the biggest NGOs in the world, begin certifying tropical snacks harvested without harm to rainforest. Also 90s to 2000, we talk the global talk about food labeling and social responsibility by the industry, and then continue gain traction with consumers. So consumer group, especially in Western and European countries, demand. Diorang banyak minta apa ni, mungkin dia lebih ada kesedaran lah on environmental issue, this and that. So they drive by them lah. Also in 2000 dan seterusnya, then only we see sustainability certification, auditing and traceability coming to the picture. So at this time we involve a lot lah other sectors, even in agriculture for example, even in manufacturing. So in Malaysia, this is based on my knowledge lah, maybe ada yang lebih tahu lagi. So we have Malaysian Timber Certification Council in 1998, and then 2004 roundtable on sustainable palm oil, it's more to vegetable oil. So it involves, it's initiated from the our Malaysian palm oil industry players lah, the big brothers, and also with the NGOs and also brands ni macam Unilever for example, yang menggunakan palm oil based product as their material lah dalam dia punya product. So starting in 2004. So if you can see the trend from the beginning until now, and I think forever lah, we move from forest and then food and agriculture, and then certification pun actually become a norm, become business as usual. Meaning certification scheme ni, kalau ada student yang tak faham lah, tak faham, you can imagine halal certification. It's similar like that lah. Contoh mungkin kalau you nak makan, you nak beli produk, you nak cari yang ada halal JAKIM. Ataupun if you go to other countries, you cari halal from that particular countries but recognized by JAKIM. Pun macam tu ada kan. So dia punya konsep, you have to look into that dimension lah daripada cara tu you kena tengok. So certification become business as usual, meaning in other sector like tourism, you know, macam food, of course lah food. And banyak lagi. So dia jadi business as usual, meaning it's no longer a privilege or no longer a something special that you need to subscribe ataupun follow lah. So dia jadi business. Even for industry, government, dia jadi satu business as usual lah. Alright, certification. So you can see from global context, from Malaysian context, is almost similar. They have something in common. If you see the international certification, sustainability certification scheme, also in Malaysia, dia punya persamaan ialah apa yang drive dia, driver dia. Meaning previously kita faham certification ni why we need, because kita nak provide assurance that kita tak buat deforestation, kita tak buat kita tak langgar hak asasi manusia or social. But actually dia punya driver, actually dia sama je dalam doesn't matter whether it be it forest ke ataupun food or agriculture. Driver dia ialah globalization. You know, kita sekarang ni since then lah, kita dah start opening up economy, supply and demand, you know, import export kan, business can open up the company in other countries, globalization, consumer lebih tergedah dengan information ataupun maklumat melalui media elektronik ataupun internet kan. Also driver, the one of the big driver is a consumer lah. Consumer group ni dia suka campaign lah, dia campaign, and then dia suka, and then normally through association ni dia punya voice boleh diterima di peringkat international or even dia punya government lah. So driver yang lain juga public opinion. Ini macam maybe kalau terms budak-budak sekarang ni insta famous lah. Dia macam orang yang famous ataupun orang yang expert individually. Dia boleh buat buku ataupun dia boleh publish content talking about sustainability ataupun deforestation. And of course NGO, one of our friend, NGO helping us in driving the certification, sustainability certification. Also of course government, especially in Malaysia, our MSPO, I will come into MSPO later, government banyak involved lah, academic in doing their research. Kalau you check Google Scholar, a lot of information on sustainability and also specific on MSPO. And then driver pun yang lain ialah business lah, because they want to do business. So there is demand, there is, and then they need to provide supply. And also they look into risk, cost and value lah to their product. Okay, one thing is driver. Second thing yang ada common between global and also local is organizational features of certification scheme. Apa ciri-ciri yang perlu ada dalam certification scheme? Ialah standard requirement, standard setting process, macam mana kita nak buat standard tersebut, pelaksanaan standard termasuk impact monitoring ataupun pelaksanaan persijilan tersebut yang Mr. Simon dah explain last week berkenaan auditing and training, competency, itu semua dalam ni lah. Also governance, this is one of the major quantum leap lah, meaning big jump for the Malaysian government to have MSPO and MPOCC, which is the governance. If you refer back to the driver just now, driver tu, it's actually happened to our country. Meaning government also receive a lot of pressure from especially the European Union is one of our biggest importer lah. Dia banyak import sawit kan. Crude palm oil ataupun dia punya derivative. So dia ada policy-policy yang menekan. I would say menekan lah at that time, menekan. For example like Amsterdam Declaration kan, contoh. And then kita pun dapat drive daripada industri, NGOs, locally and internationally, sebab Malaysia ni one of the second largest producer of palm oil lah, and also second producer for now. So Indonesia is the first. So bila government dapat pressure, so dia pun try to emulate or adopt or develop the then minister lah, I can't remember his name. In 2013, they are instructed through cabinet decision, they minta MPOB to develop MSPO MS2530-2013. MS2530 ni dia punya code standard tu. So MPOB ni bertindak sebagai badan yang pada masa tu badan standard writing organisation, badan yang merangka atau penulis standard, di mana di bawah tu dia ada dia punya komiti lah. Bahawa MPOB ni dia ada dua komiti yang membantu dalam proses menyiapkan standard MSPO. So I think big credit to MPOB lah who started all of this. Of course MPOB, Malaysian Palm Oil Board lah, lembaga minyak sawit Malaysia ni kita punya custodian lah, custodian of Malaysian palm oil industry. They involve research and also enforcement lah, research and service macam enforcement, licensing. So maybe at that time is one of the research in sustainability lah. So they come up with MSPO. So I think masih ada lagi team yang dulu buat standard ni, masih ada lagi dekat MPOB. Thank you very much. If you all listen to this, thank you very much for the contribution to the country. Also, we talk about governance. So this is the time kita nak institutionalize MSPO ni. Kita nak ada satu badan yang independent, and then dia empowered, and then dia govern MSPO. So masa tu tu cabinet decision, cabinet has decided, cabinet bukan cabinet dapur, eh? Cabinet menteri, apa ni, kementerian lah, menteri-menteri lah. So dia incorporated under apa ni, MBOCC lah, dia register under Companies Act 1965 on 10 December 2014. And then 2015, did I appoint CEO, and then I think that time we only have three employee lah, CEO, senior manager satu dan manager, HR manager. Thank you very much also for all the contribution. Now, I mean from the past or even now, our officers, our CEOs, our BOT, Board of Trustees from 2015 even until now, always support us. So we introduced the MSPO certification scheme in 2015. Okay, you have to differentiate MSPO standard and MSPO scheme. So scheme ni, scheme dia jadi, boleh jadi under the scheme kita ada other standards lah, macam biomass standard for example, or maybe MSPO trace, dia ada lebih banyak produk lah tau. So scheme ni dia macam, how to explain, okay macam ni, kalau you tengok Toyota, Honda semua tu, dia put under one passenger car. So under passenger car tu dia ada SUV, ada D segment sedan semua tu kan. So similarly, dekat-dekat automotive pun dia ada macam industrial punya vehicle. So scheme, our scheme is our scheme. So we have MSPO standard. We have maybe in the coming month or year, maybe next year kita ada biomass standard for example. So MPOCC ni council lah. Kita council di bawah kementerian. So kita governing body. Governing body meaning kita provide macam di Malaysia kita ada perlembagaan Malaysia, how to run the country based on rules of law kan. So dalam MPOCC pun kita develop system document, for example, system document mechanism untuk menjalankan pensijilan. So kita bukan, of course kita dari industri, but we are not someone who do the harvesting, manuring for example kan, benda-benda yang the technical, kita mau to certification. So kita govern, we are governed by 13 member board of trustees from various stakeholders lah, association, NGOs. Okay, so this is our vision, mission and objective. I think yang penting sekali, we need to understand MPOCC mission is to have a credible scheme and also internationally recognized lah. So kita nak satu skim yang kredibel, yang bermutu, yang berkualiti, yang padu, dan pada masa yang sama diterima dan diiktiraf di peringkat antarabangsa. When I say skim is the MSPO certification scheme lah. So ini kita punya basic roles, MPOCC punya role secara asas dia lah. But actually we do more than this lah. Okay, so secara asasnya kita admin ataupun secretariat lah. Kita buat certification processing, standard setting dengan apa ni, kerjasama Jabatan Standard Malaysia. And then we manage consultants, working group, logo, data, traceability, IT, incentive, apa-apa daripada mandat daripada kementerian, kita akan laksanakan lah. Contohnya macam kita bagi insentif untuk industri mendapatkan persetujuan MSPO. So kita akan operate the incentive lah. Dan juga kita provide training, workshop dan sebagainya lah. Also kita involve dalam kerja-kerja untuk mendapatkan pengiktirafan di peringkat antarabangsa. So kita banyak buat engagement lah di peringkat antarabangsa dengan government ataupun industry players lah. Alright, so okay, 2017 ni dia satu macam perubahan yang besar lah dalam industri sawit negara. Sebab masa ni kita buat satu consultation dengan industri ataupun melalui persatuan, dan pada masa tu menteri, yang seingat saya menteri, I think Datuk Mah Masyu Kiong, kita announce pelaksanaan mandatory MSPO secara mandatory. Mandatory meaning kita announce beginning 2020 kita dah buat mandatory, dia akan link dengan lesen MPOB. So kita announce 3 tahun lebih awal lah, supaya industri dapat bersedialah ke arah how to say, ke arah pelaksanaan secara mandatory lah. Okay, and then 2018 kita lancarkan MSPO standard supply chain. Dia ialah complete set of standard lah. Previously kita ada upstream standard. Upstream ni macam huluan kan. And then downstream hiliran. So kita ada hiliran standard yang di peringkat hiliran lah. And then kita lancarkan MSPO Trace in 2019. And then 2020 January tu last year kita dah start mandatory MSPO lah. So macam mana kita laksanakan MSPO dari sudut kita transform the whole industry, and also kita kena consider juga ada non industry, contoh macam environmental NGO, social NGO. So previously our initial position, kita start dengan when we took over 2014, kita cuma ada 16,000 hektar sawit yang disijilkan. Masa ni ialah pilot yang standard yang MPOB buat. And then 2015, 83,000. And then 2016 kita almost in full capacity lah, even though masa tu kita cuma ada I think 25 staff, officers including CEO semua. We managed to help industry to get 200 plus thousand hektar lah of certified area. So if you can imagine, we are moving towards mandatory, but kita cuma ada small team to look after the whole country, Sabah, Sarawak and Semenanjung. And then you know, sawit ni almost everywhere except KL lah. KL tak ada kan. Oh, kalau ada pun ada yang dah convert to property for example. So that time pun kita cuma ada 7 negeri saja yang certified. Accreditation program. Ini last week Mr. Simon dah explain, kita nak buat satu program akreditasi ni sama juga macam kita nak study dekat mana, UPM ke USM ke. Kita kena make sure they accredited lah by MQA kan, Course to Malaysian Qualification Agency. Kalau saya tak silap, okay. Kalau salah, boleh betulkan lah. So, kita buat accreditation program for auditor, for certification body ataupun badan pensijilan yang membuat audit. So, kita start from scratch lah that time. So, bila kita lancarkan program akreditasi dengan Jabatan Standard Malaysia untuk skim MSPO, kita cuma ada dua badan pensijilan. Meaning badan pensijilan ni paling senang lah kalau student nak faham, dia macam SIRIM lah. Kan SIRIM ataupun paling senang SIRIM lah. Dia akan pergi audit dan dia akan bagi you logo. Contoh macam tu kan. So masa tu kita cuma ada dua. I think kita ada SIRIM and DPS lah that time. Nama company tersebut. So auditor pun masa tu kita cuma ada 20. And then peer reviewer. Peer reviewers ni macam dalam audit report tu kena check oleh peer review lah. Macam you buat thesis ke apa, you kena ada peer review dulu ke semua tu kan. So dia akan check dulu audit report. So system document to govern the whole scheme pun kita baru start buat lah. I think somewhere 2015-2016 lah. So in 2020, actually when we enter 2020 lah, ataupun to be exact, as of December 2019, kita dah dapat maybe around 3 million hektar of certified MSPO certified oil palm plantation yang kita dah sijilkan. Kilang kita ada 343 kilang. And then processing facility ni kita ada refinery, kilang, biodiesel plant, di bawah standard supply chain certification standard SCCS ni dalam 166 processing facilities lah. And then at that time kita dah ada 19 syarikat pengauditan, syarikat pengauditan. And then roughly we have 200 auditors dan juga peer reviewer around 100. And also in 2019 kita diterima pakai sebagai sourcing code for Japan Olympic. So bila dia nak import bahan-bahan makanan, semuanya kena sustainable. Perlu sustainable. So dia minta dia recognize MSPO lah as one of the sustainable sourcing code lah, together with other scheme like RSPO or ISPO. So how we close the gap and transform the industry? Okay, from our initial position to achieve 2020, kita buat simulation lah. Kita buat simulation, time motion study, simulation in order to certify how many hectare, how many auditors are required, how many CB are required, how many peer reviewer are required, how many audits need to be conducted, and then how many training that we need to do in term of scheme. Also, nanti I explain further. And then kita pakai four-prong strategy. This is very basic lah. I think we have more than this, but I try to make it as concise as possible. Firstly, we need to tackle the scheme itself, the MSPO scheme. Kita kena increase and improve scheme capacity and capability. Number two is the Malaysian palm oil industry. Ini yang paling penting juga sebab dia orang yang akan disijilkan. So kita kena transform dia orang from zero to hero lah. Lebih kurang macam tu. From nothing to something. Maybe some of them already certified with RSPO. So but a lot of them belum ada experience lagi dengan pensijilan. And then kita juga buat partnership and collaboration and also our communication lah. Okay. So talking about scheme, as I mentioned earlier, kita rushing buat scheme, buat governing certification system. Kita juga rushing nak increase number of certification body through our simulation, our studies, our blueprint last time lah. So kita develop training program sebab kita tak ada capacity nak train all auditor ataupun potential auditor. So we need to develop satu program, endorsement program to training provider. Di mana training provider ni kita proses, kita appoint dia orang, jadi dia ada satu proses lah, proses untuk macam kita interview lah, ada proses dia kan. So kita appoint dia orang dan dia orang akan pergi train potential auditor lah, pre-qualification lah. So competency requirement kita kena buat a bit loose, not downgrading the quality, tapi kita kurangkan sedikit, bagi longgar sikit supaya ramai orang boleh masuk lah, and then become the auditor. But of course, with strict requirement lah, strict requirement. So kita increase number of auditor, number of audit. So in order to increase number of audit, we need to increase number of auditor, number of technical expert, number of peer reviewer. And then kita juga develop document lah, macam for example like combined audit checklist. Kita nak assist those yang already certified dengan RSPO, the big brothers, big companies ni, supaya diorang boleh jimatkan cost dan juga dia boleh conduct audit tu sekali lah ataupun pada masa atau hari yang sama lah. So kita nak assist industry players kan. So kita pakai pelbagai jenis approach lah. Also kita develop means of assessing compliance. Ini macam guidance document lah to assist industry or user macam mana nak certify, apa yang dia perlu buat. So kita juga memperkenalkan group certification. This is not new in other scheme. So kita benarkan jugalah group certification ni, maksud dia under satu sijil kita ada banyak entities lah, banyak company. So itu group certification lah. Dan pada masa yang sama kita make sure quality lah, quality of the scheme lah, training this and that. Although of course nothing is perfect, but we always keep need to improve lah kan. So okay, palm oil industry pun sama juga. Kita adopt PDCA ordering cycle lah. This is the iterative process for continually improving products, people and services. This is very basic kalau you all familiar dengan quality management system. So kita implement PDCA. So firstly kita plan macam mana kita nak tackle industry ni. Macam mana kita nak transform dia orang, macam mana kita nak build the capacity of the industry players to be able to comply to MSPO standard requirement. So kita formulate lah, kita formulate module, content, macam mana approach kita nak buat. Kita nak panggil pergi ladang ke, kita nak panggil dalam satu dewan ke, and then kita buat profiling. This is very important lah. At that time kita cuma ada satu atau dua staff yang buat profiling for the whole country. And then profiling meaning kita buat based on traffic light indicator tu, kita nak tengok siapa yang totally zero, siapa yang dah appoint consultant ataupun dalam proses preparation. And then kita categorize juga sesiapa yang dalam proses pensijilan ataupun audit, dan juga siapa yang dah disijilkan. So through profiling, kita narrow down kita punya scope lah. Scope ni maksud dia kita define scope ni. Okay, kalau red, this is priority. Kalau yellow, maybe no need lah sebab yellow dia dalam proses persijilan. Kalau, sorry, from red to orange. Orange ni dia dalam proses persediaan. Tapi dia belum dalam proses audit. Then yellow siapa, then green siapa. So we will focus on more on orange and red lah at that time. And then bila kita dah plan, kita buat lah. Kita do, we do nationwide rollout of jelajah MSPO lah. We call it that time jelajah MSPO, but it consists of various activities lah, like awareness program, workshop, training, roadshow, and site visit. So after kita buat workshop, even until the extent that we appoint third party to train everyone about documentation, kita pergi field visit, kita pergi melawat aset-aset yang dah certified, kita ambil gambar, kita share. You know, it's a very very challenging work actually. And then kita pergi, once we completed all the program, kita buat evaluation lah, kita check and monitor the progress of each category. From red, we need to ensure from red they change to orange. From orange category, they change to yellow. Kalau dia dah sampai yellow tu, kita rasa lega lah sebab dia dah dalam proses persijilan. Tinggal tunggu disijilkan saja, macam tu. And then act. Lastly, dalam cycle ni act, meaning kalau successful, why? If successful, we will incorporate into the next program ataupun kita improvise. Kalau tak successful, ada yang masih tak boleh buat lagi, then kita restart with different plan lah. So kita kena re-strategize our approach lah. Mungkin previously dia buat training, so maybe lepas ni dia masih tak boleh juga, kita buat workshop. Workshop ni lagi detail lah, lagi detail. Dia kena bawa laptop, dia kena bawa paling basic, kena bawa laptop, internet connection. So dia terus buat dia punya documentation. Itu workshop lah. Okay, this is basic lah. So as I said, it's very tough with very limited resources. We need to work with apa ni? We need to transform, or we need to ensure industry are certified before 2020 because it's mandatory. But I think the point is, I think we must keep moving forward lah. Itu je. Doesn't matter lah. Of course, nothing is perfect. People will say, oh, this training, the standard is not apa, the punya quality not standardized. Ada yang okay, ada yang tak. Yeah, we acknowledge that because of everyone has the limitation. But I think well done from the team also lah. From the team now until now and then, I think to take care of the whole industry is not easy. One with one organization, and the mandate is actually big. From the ministry to NPOCC. So also we will never forget how MPOB is one of our apa ni biggest partner lah. Because if you for your information, in Malaysia we have at least 20% independent smallholders by hectareage, meaning dalam keluasan ladang sawit ni 20% lebih kurang, minimum 30% is owned by independent smallholders. So independent smallholders ni, it's like my father or your father or your uncle, atuk, semua yang ada kebun sawit sendiri. So this all apa ni, this category under the purview of MPOB lah. So MPOB tolong facilitate smallholders. This is the biggest challenge actually. Smallholders and also the medium sized estate below 500 hectare. In order for them to comply to the MSPO requirement, very difficult. Especially we have challenge apa ni? We have limitation on manpower, and also demography of independent smallholder ni dia punya apa ni? Diversity, kan? Dia punya diversity dalam smallholders ni different level of how to say. I mean, we do respect different level of understanding or education, kan? So awareness, and also one of the important thing is number 5 lah, sustainable financial capacity to support certification costs. So yalah, kalau makan gaji ataupun not makan gaji, kais pagi makan pagi contoh macam tu kan, at that time harga sawit pun tak berapa cantik lah. It's not like naik today, I think 4,000 plus per ton. Last time I think even below 2,000 kan. So it's very challenging lah. What I try to say is very challenging, and MPOB I think did a very good job. Even now, until now helping the smallholders to come on board lah in certification. As I said, we cannot do this alone, so we need to have a very strategic partnership and collaboration lah with multi stakeholders, with the government, especially state government, Sabah, Sarawak, and also Semenanjung. Dia tolong kita dari sudut policy and then institutional support, meaning dia appoint dia punya agency ataupun dia punya apa ni, dia punya jentera lah, dia punya jentera dalam state government tu untuk bantu kita, bantu MSPO lah, bantu MSPO and also tax through LHDN kita ada bagi tax exemption kepada siapa yang disijilkan, and then kita government through our ministry bagi insentif. MPOB kita buat awareness pasal regulation, licensing regulation pasal MSPO, and then kita kerja juga dengan labor department, HR ataupun human resource department, ministry of human resources, environmental, wildlife, semua itulah. Also kita kerja dengan NGO pun penting sebab kita nak reach people, so kita perlukan NGO punya expertise, ideas and also manpower. Everyone want to achieve the same agenda, which is sustainability. And then kita kerja juga dengan financial institution, be it lah bank negara, association of bank, individual bank, dalam rangka satu polisi kewangan di mana MSPO ni diterima sebagai salah satu instrumen ataupun tools untuk kita bagi financial service ataupun financial support to any business, macam tu. So kita juga engage dengan trade and investment entity Bursa Malaysia, similar juga dia punya konsep ataupun objektif dengan financial institution. Kita juga bekerjasama dengan big boys companies, ini company-company sawit yang besar lah. Kalau you biasa tengok dekat Bursa Malaysia tu kan, plantation company ada banyak kan yang besar-besar tu, then we work with them in apa ni, reaching out to their suppliers, and then they juga buat model certification, group certification untuk for their supplier. So kita juga kerja dengan association, universities, you know, they assist in resources, ideas and also programs lah. That time thanks to, I think masa tu kita juga bekerjasama dengan UiTM Jasin. So dia hantar dia punya student to help us doing our workshop lah. So dia ada yang good exposure lah. Masa tu dia jadi, ada yang jadi MC, ada yang jadi note takers, ada yang jadi macam kita buat satu program lah. Macam you all buat program dekat university lah. Macam tu lah kita bagi exposure, and then dia berpeluang untuk berkomunikasi dengan industry players lah at that time. And then kita pun kerja dengan community lah. Community ni ketua kampung, tuai rumah kan, sebab dia lebih senang nak bercakap dengan orang-orang di sekeliling dia. So kita catch ataupun kita tackle the ketua kampung semua ni lah. Okay, last but not least, the appreciation to all those involved in the certification lah. And also I think not only this, I think kita we have more than this lah, tapi kalau I lupa letak logo tu, so sorry, my apology, tapi I just want to say that we cannot do this alone lah. Basically we really need everyone's hands, doesn't matter lah any contribution in term of your brain, your sweat or your not blood lah, not blood, just sweat, maybe you punya perlu, you punya idea, you punya brain, you punya manpower kan, tolong kita to transform the whole industry. So it's not easy, but tapi sangat-sangat berbaloi lah, sangat-sangat berbaloi. And then last but not least, our communication, internal communication is we need to ensure internally kita we sing the same song, meaning kalau ini lagi nyanyi Metallica, semua kena nyanyi Metallica lah, tak boleh ada nyanyi Metallica, tak boleh ada nyanyi Celine Dion for example ataupun Limp Bizkit. I bagi contoh lah kan, meaning internal communication strategy, I think thanks to our communication team, very small and very very small lah, very small team, and then kita ensure communication kita semua standardized, kita sampaikan kepada stakeholders. Also our marketing communication pun and public relation, kita involved dengan various programs or seminar or events or apa, kita present paper, kita engage industry players kan, kita engage media, you know, mainstream media ataupun through video or through apa ni, above the line or below the line, meaning through radio, through paper, newspaper, macam tu lah. So Selain daripada transform industri, kita juga kena make sure our communication to our other stakeholders, macam international stakeholders, local stakeholders, rakyat, for example, dia faham apa tu MSP, dia tahu. So kerja tu is ongoing lah, even until now pun kita masih buat lagi. Okay, the way forward. The way forward, shaping the future of MSPO, delivering a national promise. So, shaping the future is not easy. But for now, we stick to our, we have our vision and mission, something that we need to ensure we are on track lah. On track meaning kita tak tersasar daripada kita punya tujuan lah. Kita punya tujuan pelaksanaan MSPO ataupun penubuhan MPOCC itu sendiri lah. Kita kena achieve our vision and mission, credibility and recognition. And also kita juga link dengan dasar agri komoditi negara. This is the latest one lah, latest policy from our Ministry of Plantation Industries and Commodities. Di mana saya simpulkan, simpulkan lama tak pakai pekat tani lah, simpulkan. Capture leading position in sustainability and secondly improving market access. As we all know, ataupun kalau ada yang belum tahu, roughly around 80% of our palm oil export to international lah, to other countries. Kita export 80%, 20% kita use local consumption, kita guna di dalam Malaysia. So if you can imagine 80% tu kita export. So we need to have something to penetrate the market lah. Selain daripada leading position in sustainability, perlu juga market access. So it's actually linked to our vision and mission and also dasar agri-commodity negara. So to you see the red color kan? So maybe what we need to do in maybe a bit more detail lah. We need to have a credible and robust system. So first, number one is governance lah. The governance of the scheme, the institutional arrangement, the kita punya independency, impartiality, separation of power and segregation of duties. You know, kita kena ada satu badan yang boleh, kita kena jadi satu badan ataupun kita kena ada sistem yang boleh handle any conflict or conflict of interest ataupun dispute among the stakeholders. So kita kena ada satu good governance lah. Secondly, our product accessibility requirement, we need to ensure robust standards requirement, multi-stakeholders input, practical and also incorporating continuous improvement plan. So ini memang standard ni, I think last week Mr. Simon dah explain juga, kita dah sekarang dalam proses review kan, kita dah buat semakan kita punya standard, kita buat banyak improvement dalam kita punya standard lah. And also number three is impact. So sistem juga kita perlu tahu, kita kena strengthen measures, mechanism and impact monitoring. Macam mana kita nak measure atau monitor impact pensijilan MSPO ni, sistem ni kepada MSPO ecosystem ataupun industri ataupun kepada Malaysia as a whole in term of maybe environmental, social, macam mana kita boleh kurangkan kadar, bukan kadar lah, kita boleh kurangkan allegation of forced or child labor, buruh kasar, buruh paksa. Macam mana kita boleh buktikan MSPO ni, sistem yang kita ada ni boleh mengurangkan kadar penyahutanan. Okay, deforestation. Contoh macam itulah. Also number four, sistem tu kenalah ada satu teknologi yang sangat baik lah. Meaning sistem yang baik, traceability, ada data security, efficient dan juga efektif. So sistem IT system atau teknologi ni mungkin kita boleh kita follow the new ataupun the latest technology like blockchain for example. Macam mana kita nak incorporate those technology dalam kita punya credible to make the system robust and credible lah. Okay. Improving market access. Ini kerja-kerja yang I think from now starting this year onwards yang kita dah pun try to expand lah, to focus lah. Kita creating demands, awareness, brand positioning, mutual recognition, kita bekerjasama dengan government of other countries, you know. And then through partnership, collaboration, through government to government, G2G, B2B, business to business, consumer groups, associations, etc., etc., etc. So ini yang the big our next challenge lah. Okay. So how to do this? We just repeat the four prong strategy. This is basic, as I mentioned. Maybe we have more than this. And then we need to improve and intensify efforts lah. So we still need to continue our to improve our scheme credibility, capacity and capability. And then we need to transform Malaysian and global palm oil industry. So why I say Malaysian? Because kita ada standard baru. So bila ada standard baru, kita nak ensure industri pun kena comply dengan standard yang baru. So kita kena repeat lah program-program yang kita buat sebelum ni. And then kita expand kepada global lah in term of supply chain certification. So kita engage dengan company-company, foreign companies, traders di luar negara lah. Through partnership and collaboration. Okay, local and international. So kita expand our collaboration not only in Malaysia but also in at international level lah. And also similarly our communication. What is our next strategy? We need to ensure our direction, strategic communication, mainstream, social campaign, and then we need to target all audience, local and international. All right. So okay, challenges and opportunities. So all this while, we always presented issues and challenges. So people say it's negative, macam tak ada positivity. Okay, fine, then we accept, then we change to challenges and opportunities. So challenges is policy and expectation. We are talking about internally in Malaysia, very easy. Kita boleh, you know, kita ada kementerian yang look after the policy kan. Tetapi when we go internationally, dia punya expectation different, dia punya policy different. So different countries ada different requirement, for example. And then when you have different policy, dia punya industri pula ada different needs. So kita kena, itu challenge lah. How we can apa ni be able to fulfill that apa expectation lah. Alright, number two, the challenges is on credible and price advantage. Macam mana kita nak buat MSPO certification scheme, ataupun kalau student masih tak faham, cuba imagine halal JAKIM logo tu. Okay, macam mana kita nak buat MSPO ni bukan sahaja credible tetapi juga price advantage, meaning we are very competitive in term of pricing or cost. Kita for industry is to subscribe to it is lower than our competitors. How to explain this? Okay, the easiest way to imagine is Proton Gili lah, Gili kan. You see dia punya vehicle, dia punya kereta semua dia ada high tech punya sistem dalam kereta tu yang sama dengan standard European ataupun Japanese. Tapi dia boleh reduce the price. You know, meaning dia masih ada quality dia punya sistem tapi dengan harga yang mampu milik. Mampu milik, I tengok comparison, I ada tengok lah, comparison dia mampu milik lah dengan spek yang sama, features yang sama. You compare Geely Chinese, China punya, Japanese and also European of course lah, memang boleh, dia lagi rendah. So we have to look into that angle lah, macam mana kita nak buat MSPO ni, quality dia terjamin tetapi juga price advantage lah ataupun competitive. And then the challenge number three is development lah, all development, our system development, IT development, human resource development, expertise development, retaining talent development in our organisation. Macam mana kita nak retain kita punya expertise, kita punya staff yang kita dah train from 2015-2016, kita nak make sure dia retain and then make sure dia improve so that we can deliver, we can support MSPO certification. So itu semua challenges lah dari segi human resource jugalah. And then opportunities, then from challenges we can find opportunities lah. So by having different expectation, MSPO can be more flexible. Flexible in a way that kita boleh fulfill. Sometimes other countries tu dia nak high requirement. Then we can maybe accommodate that requirement. So kita akan jadi lebih flexible lah. Secondly, through credible and fast advantage challenge ni kita boleh position our brand lah. As I mentioned earlier, kita akan position MSPO maybe if not on par, if not better, but maybe on par lah for the time being lah with our competitor. And then also we open up a new apa ni potential financial support lah through collaboration with universities. I forgot to mention also, I think one of our dasar agri commodity negara for MPOCC yang kita perlu achieve is to commission a study on MSPO tau. So commission a study on MSPO. So we haven't decided anything lah on the title, what not. Kita tak discuss lagi, tapi kita perlu bekerja dengan university lah lepas ni juga to achieve our dasar agri commodity. Alright, so in conclusion, MSPO is here to stay, and not only will be the brand for Malaysian palm oil that is green, certified to credible standards and traceable, but also will transform the global palm oil supply chain. So it's a very tough journey, and we know it's very difficult journey moving forward, but we have to remember, in whatever we do, success is not final, failure is not fatal. It is the courage that continue that counts. So doesn't matter lah whether you are a student, you having difficulties in your studies, ataupun especially during the pandemic, maybe our parents affected kan. So similarly with MBOCC and MSPO, we just need to keep moving, and then must have the courage to continue lah, to continue slowly but surely. So with that, thank you very much, Doctor, for having me today. Yep. Over to you, Doctor. Thanks.
Thank you very much, Mr. Hezbollah, for that very detailed and informative speech. I think we definitely learned a lot about the certification process. So I would like to invite the participants to feel free to ask any questions to Mr. Hezbollah. They can ask directly or can use the chat box.
Oh, we have Q&A.
We already have a question actually from Sari in the chat box. He's asking whether there is a link for the certification. Maybe you can advise the participants on where they can, which website they link, can refer to.
Okay, the best. Okay, if you want to know about MSPO, MPOCC, mpocc.org.my. But if you want to know more about MSPO certification, mspotrace.org.my. Let me check first. MSPO Trace. I let me share my screen. MSPO Trace. Okay, correct. It's mspotrace.org.my. Okay, this is our MSPO Trace lah. mspotrace.org.my. You can have the information of our certified areas, processing facilities, you know, you can even check on the certified list, certified companies, smallholders. You can explore this later, right?
Okay.
Right.
So while we wait for the other participants to ask questions, Mr. Hezbollah, is there anything that the general public, I mean, people who are not directly linked to the oil palm industry, is there anything that they can do to help achieve or improve the current certification program?
Yes, this is very subjective. Normally, people will go through their preferences lah. Kalau you prefer through environmental, then maybe you can provide the comment. Currently, we're doing our standard public comment, so you can go through the environmental aspect of the standard. And also maybe if you social, you more to social, or if you all more to macam awareness program, you can always reach us, contact us, and see what we can do lah. We can plan something for the community, for the maybe for example for the kindergarten, maybe for the schools pun boleh juga, no issues. Yeah.
So what is your personal aspirations or personal dreams regarding the Malaysian palm oil industry? What's the, for the future, your personal opinion? What are your hopes, to put it simply?
I hope I still with MPOCC first. maybe I still consider young lah kan. So I don't know, in the future, maybe I will go to continue my personal journey. I'm not sure. I also maybe also interested in teaching. So I'm not sure what is my future, but for MPOCC and MSPO, I think MSPO ni the challenge now is how to make sure the 80% of the importing countries or companies outside Malaysia can recognize MSPO lah. So I hope one day we can achieve that. If even if not 100%, maybe above 50% out of the 80% export tu kita dah capture or penetrate the market lah. So this one will be, I think my CEO will present the paper lah, I think next week kan. Encik Hafiz will talk more about trade, you know. Tu dia akan be lah, lebih detail lah I think. So yeah, that's my personal view lah, or my personal journey and also my hope for MSPO and MBOCC, and also to retain the talent lah. So people in MBOCC very talented one. So to retain is not easy, but hopefully we can retain them until I don't know, until forever lah. Wherever, when we have the scheme, we still need the people to run. Yeah.
Mr. Espel, actually we have a couple of questions in the chat. One is from Shagan. Shagan is asking whether MSPO scheme can help to reduce or slow down deforestation rate in Malaysia.
If you talk about scientific or academic studies, I tak pernah review lagi lah the paper lah. Tapi in our communication trade communication through our ministry, kita akan incorporate MSPO and then we will talk about MSPO because most of the countries now asking about sustainability certification. So it did help lah. Maybe it's not actually tangible. It's not tangible. Maybe intangible, but we try to influence. Hopefully, this is not a bad word lah. Influence the government of other countries to also accept. So if you say boost, maybe is still supply and demand juga. If you're talking about price, CPO price, supply and demand, demand tinggi, supply kurang, harga sekarang 4,000 plus. But we talk about MSPO certification, still new lah. Kita belum ada lagi company yang certified overseas lah. Yep.
Okay, we have another new question from Baba Anik. He's asking regarding how can MSPO benefit the smallholder, I think smallholder all palm owners in the long term.
Long term through their practice, because sustainability ni dia ada component best practices. Kalau MPOB ada, dia boleh cerita banyak. Dia ada buat study, dia ada paper juga buat apa improvement. Yang ni I dah tengok paper ni. Dia ada buat satu paper, I think very new, I think 2018, 2019. Dia dah buatkan secara empirical study macam mana smallholders boleh berubah lah dia punya income, dia punya production, dia punya kesedaran tentang environment dan juga safety. Memang ada lah. Memang ada. And then I think we miss out one question from Shadan, how MSPO scheme helps to slow down deforestation rate? This is a very tough question. I'm not sure. I don't know how. To be frank, we haven't done any academic or scientific research on the correlation between MSPO and deforestation rate. But I can share with you one of the NGOs, like Global Forest Watch, did mention MSPO ada deforestation rate slowing down due to the policy punya impact of MSPO. Meaning we need to have a policy impact lah, policy drive from the government to slowing down deforestation. Yep. And then from Ayman Hakim, is there any smallholders or private company that do not aware about MSPO or they still not applying the MSPO? Kalau nak kata tak aware tu, tipu lah. Kalau ada kita jumpa company cakap, you kena buat MSPO, or kita langsung tak tahu MSPO. Itu memang penipuan lah, penipuan. Diorang tahu, semua dah dapat surat, especially bila kita nak buat enforcement through MPOB, semua dah tahu. Tapi ada yang masih belum buat, tapi diorang mostly dia dah dalam transition lah. Dia nak tutup kedai, dia nak close shop, ataupun dia nak tutup plantation, ataupun dia nak tukar ke perumahan lah, macam residential ataupun property. So dia tak ambil lagi MSPO sebab dia nak convert dia punya tanah tu. So ada juga, and then for smallholders pun masih ramai lagi. Ini yang kerja yang MPOB masih buat lagi lah untuk bantu smallholders lah. Okay.
So Senang kata, the information dah sampai dah ke pihak sepatutnya, tapi sama ada mereka dengar ke tak, itu up to the pihak.
Yeah. Can you imagine from 2016 until 2019 lah. So if people say, actually soalan ni banyaklah kita encountered previously ya. Ada yang claim, I mean even until the extent of blaming us, kita tak tahu, tak aware. Impossible. So need to be fair to us also, very small team, and then we managed to engage everyone. Of course with the assistance and facilitation from other agencies, as I mentioned, the collaboration. So yeah.
Actually, so we have a very interesting question from, I think, a student, Firdaus. He's asking, how do you start a career in MPOC, especially to retain the talent? Maybe you can look for new talent, right? So what is the requirement or criteria?
My HR manager or corporate affairs manager maybe have the answer lah, but from my personal experience, it is good if you have, before you join council ataupun specifically MPOCC lah, maybe you need to have, you have some working experience in the industry. Doesn't matter lah, as an agronomist, as a planters, as a chemist, as a, you working in the downstream, upstream, doesn't matter. At least you know something. Kalau you tak tahu langsung pun, kita boleh je. Kita ada buat program management training, but it's very limited lah. Management training, we train everyone, and then kita absorb things like that lah.
We have a question from Professor Rosunani regarding the cultivation of oil palm on peat soil at Sarawak. So is it under the scheme of MSP or what does it say, especially on the impact of carbon loss?
I couldn't say macam in the case of deforestation and MSPO, the correlation. Because when you say about carbon loss ni, you can have scientific evidence lah. Maybe through academic studies lah, I don't know. So, banyak orang buat research pasal peat ni. Tapi to have a solid reason to link MSPO and MSPO and peat and carbon loss tu, I cannot comment on that. I tak tahu, to be fair. Tetapi dalam our MSPO standard requirement, the current one, I'm talking about the current standard, not the revised new standard yang currently under public comment. The current one, kita benarkan penanaman sawit di peat soil, tetapi kena follow MPOB guideline ataupun industry best practices. So the existing peat lah, but maybe I also hope that in the future kita dah stop planting of oil palm on peat lah. So we just manage whatever we have for now lah. Then itu memerlukan komitmen government juga, our ministry and also state government. Sebab we have to remember, hutan, tanah, air semua tu di bawah bidang kuasa kerajaan negeri, bukan kerajaan persekutuan. So it's a long story lah. Tapi carbon loss tu of course lah, people did that the research lah. I think if I can still remember correctly, my degree punya ni 2010 tu pun pasal peat dekat Sarawak lah, peat dengan forest lah. So memang ada release lah, of course kan. Cuma the amount tu I tak sure. Alright. So okay, my team, our communication team bagi tahu webinar 4 will talk about career in palm oil. This is I think semua interested lah.
Especially for students.
Yeah, like myself, I didn't think about working in the industry pun. I cuma apply cari kerja je lah. The intention just cari kerja, but suddenly masuk. So, just go with it lah. And then, from Edwina Joyce, how do MPOCC, MPOA and MPOB relate to each other regarding the implementation of MSPO? Okay, MSPOCC, kita buat scheme. Kita governing body, scheme owner, MSPO. MPOB pula, badan pelaksanaan MSPO untuk pekebun kecil. Dan juga research, dan juga dia buat penguatkuasaan undang-undang sawit di Malaysia ni, tu MPOB. Manakala MPOA pula ialah satu persatuan, itu ialah persatuan sawit lah. So persatuan sawit ni, contribution dia dari sudut expertise dan juga financial lah, financial support. And so maybe you forgot one agency juga yang penting, which is MPOC. Malaysian Palm Oil Council, dia buat palm oil punya promotional lah, locally and also internationally. How to be the MSPO auditor. Okay, first, I cuba bagi tahu based on our current document lah, current requirement. Pre-qualification, in order to become auditor, you must have at least 3 years experience in palm oil industry. Doesn't matter, as I mentioned earlier, doesn't matter upstream, downstream, ataupun you are agronomist ke apa, whatever lah yang you dalam industry, you can have at least 3 years. And then you can attend training, MSPO training, and also ISO training on integrated management system training. Also, you need to undergo how many mandates of audit, hours I think, hours or mandates of audit, meaning you kena train dengan CD, certification body. Certification body tu akan bawa you pergi audit. So you kena buat you punya audit log, kumpul you punya jam. Jam ke mandate? Sorry, I forgot this one. So you kena kumpul, and then only when you fulfill all the pre-qualification, then only you can become the auditor. But the basic one, you need to have at least 3 years experience in the industry. Sebab kalau you tak ada experience in that industry, dan bila you pergi audit, orang yang you audit tu dia lebih experience, so memang susah lah. 20 mandates, ni I punya staff bagi tahu 20 mandates, kena kumpulkan lah. Right? How to be peer review competent person? Current requirement, you kena attend training, and then you kena at least 7 years in the industry. Doesn't matter lah kalau you buat paper research on palm oil pun, kalau you daripada university pun boleh. Kita ada ramai juga peer reviewer daripada university, UM, UPM, USM, UKM, ada banyak juga. So minimum 7 years. This is based on current requirement lah, but maybe we will change the requirement in the future lah. Yang penting you can have experience lah, at least. Okay, any link can share sir or contact number for applying the MSPO auditor. Okay. Website, let me share MPOCC website .org sekejap ah. You actually can contact the certification body, MSPO certification body. Okay, I share screen . Okay, you pergi website ni, mpocc.org.my/certification bodies, ataupun you boleh pergi MSPO. MSPO kan? You pergi certification bodies. So, ini ialah syarikat-syarikat yang boleh menjalankan skim MSPO. So, you boleh contact dia orang lah. Klik. Cari contact person ataupun macam mana, you contact dia orang. You carilah dia punya contact and then you apply. Sebab kita buat third party auditing. So bukan MPOCC yang buat audit, tapi yang audit ni ialah third party lah, badan persijilan. Macam tu. Okay.
Yeah, but I think it's also be covered in our fourth webinar regarding careers in
Apa beza RSP? Okay, tengok atas sekejap. How about any link? Okay. How about smallholder that still not have legal right on their land and only possess a... Okay. From my knowledge, kita selalu juga meeting dengan MPOB. Sekarang ni MPOB cuma certify those yang ada valid, yang legal. Meaning ada valid documentation. Land title ataupun license lah. So yang belum ada tu, yang I tahu diorang baru try to solve the issue lah with the state government. Tetapi dalam our system currently diorang, kita cuma include those yang legal. Meaning even in the training yang MPOB buat, they kena make sure semua ni dah legal dulu, then they will go to the next phase lah, training, certification macam tu. So basically it's work in progress lah, those yang belum legal. Okay. Dia ada kerjasama state government dengan federal government. Okay, tuan, apa beza RSPO dengan MSPO? Harus juga mempunyai. Okay, kenapa RSPO company perlu juga dapat MSPO? The answer is simple, because this is the legal requirement. Okay, in order to have MPOB, like, okay, macam ni, ladang, company, kalau you nak operate ladang ataupun kilang, you kena ada lesen MPOB. So, salah satu syarat lesen MPOB ni, you kena ada MSPO. So, sebelum you, before we talk about RSPO, you need to ensure if you want to operating in Malaysia, you need to have MSPO lah. Because this is the pre-requirement in order for you to get your MPOB license to do business. Okay, so itu reason dia lah. Paling senang, paling straightforward lah. Is the government punya ni lah. Okay. Okay. Peer reviewer training di mana dapat latihan, nanti kita akan inform dekat website. Kita akan announce dekat website. Then kita akan blast email lah normally to our stakeholders lah. Kalau ada, then we will call for training lah. Sekejap. Adakah perubahan kerajaan ni menjejaskan perjalanannya? Saya tengok tak terjejas lah perjalanan tu. Alhamdulillah masih di jalan yang benar lah, di jalan yang lurus lah. Tak ada perubahan lagi lah. Sebab ini bukan personal punya inisiatif. Yeah, this is national initiative. So whoever coming in power, they will need to continue and support lah, support the initiative, the industry. Peer reviewer, ada tadi soalan kan? Beza RSPO and MSPO. Okay, beza RSPO and MSPO dari sudut pelaksanaan, yang ni mandatory, RSPO mandatory. Dari sudut cost, straightforward, cost untuk mendapatkan RSPO lebih mahal daripada MSPO. Dari sudut quality, dari sudut standard requirement atau quality, yes, RSPO lebih stringent. Tetapi MSPO pun, we cannot underestimate also, through our standard review pun, is quite a big jump from the earlier standard lah. Then, apa lagi? Comparison dari segi, okay, RSPO ni, dia boleh certify those operating oil pump in other countries. Contoh macam you ada company di Liberia, you boleh dapat, you boleh subscribe to RSPO lah. But MSPO only in Malaysia. Kalau you operating in contoh macam company, I bagi contoh IOI lah, dia ada company di luar negara. So di luar negara dia tak perlu MSPO, dalam Malaysia saja dia perlu MSPO. And then dari sudut, I think cukup lah kot. Kalau nak cerita banyak lagi, dia punya perbezaan. I have a question. Ni yang tadi kan? Dah habis lah, Doktor. Ada lagi soalan?
Yeah, I think you have already covered all the questions. There's a lot of questions. I think we've covered all of it so far. But regarding the students especially who are interested to get a career in the palm oil industry, tak kisahlah di, MPOCC ke, generally speaking, there will be a webinar, the fourth webinar, which will be covering a career in the palm oil industry. So please feel free to join that. Okay. So if there is no more questions, I would like to inform before ending today's webinar that there will be another webinar series or webinar talk next week, which will be on the exploring the world marketability and opportunity of MSPO certification as the sustainable choice for palm oil. The speaker for this webinar will be Mr. Muhammad Hafiz Abdul Rahman, who is the CEO of MPOCC. It'll be on 18 June, on Friday next week, at 10 a.m. Okay? So I hope that we can all, maybe we can see you there for the next webinar. Once again, I would like to thank Mr. Hezbollah and our participants for joining us today. It had been a very informative and very interesting talk. I think that we really learned a lot about the palm oil industry. And I hope to see you all again very soon, hopefully for the next week's webinar. Goodbye and have a great day.